In this video, we'll discuss the convolutional neural network with respect to MNIST. So we'll have our convolutional neural network class. In the class constructor, we'll have 16 output channels for the first layer and 32 output channels for the second layer. And you can use your own, and as they are variables, you can use your own number of channels when you construct your own object. So for the, we have the first convolutional layer. We have a kernel size of 5. And a kernel size of 2. And we have the second convolutional layer. And we have a kernel size of 5 and a kernel size of 2. And then we'll use the output to our linear layer. And just to note, if you adjust any of the parameters with respect to kernel size, you'll have to adjust these numbers. And these might take a little more work, but you can try different output, but you can change out 1 and out 2. You have a lot more flexibility in choosing out 1 and out 2. So let's examine this linear object before. So for each channel, we'll have 7x7 activation. And if we use our default value of out 2 equals 32, we'll have a total of 32 channels. So we want to input this into a linear layer, in this case. And as such, we'll have 32 for every channel times 7x7 for each of the activation maps. And we'll input that to our linear layer. So we have our first 16 convolutional kernels. And then for our second layer, we'll have 16 inputs and 32 outputs. And just a note, red is larger than blue in these images. So let's simplify that with our little diagram. All right. So it's very similar to the original diagram, except there's a lot more kernels. So we look at our activation and pooling layer. And our activation and pooling layer. So let's look at the activation map for the first convolutional layer. And that's that guy over there. So let's look at the output of the activations for the different kernels. So if we look at our first kernel, and we look at the outputs for all the channels, we see that these ones are relatively large. If we look at the 7, we see they look pretty similar, except for these activation maps over there. They seem to have larger values compared to the 1. So here are convolutional layers. And we'll have 32 outputs. And just to note, I couldn't fit all the outputs in one slide. Let's squeeze them all together and look at the outputs combined. Activation map, and the output after we apply the activation function for the 1, and similar for the 7. So let's compare them side by side. And if you look at the output of these activations, we see that the 7 has a lot more in this region. These activations are looking at different parts of the image. And that's it.